should work. Well, I'm doing the drive of shame. I'm not real happy about that one. Drew everything up perfectly. Birds did exactly what I wanted them to do this morning. But, obviously, as you guys saw, so Dane was off to the left. I honestly haven't looked at the footage yet, so I don't know if he, like, got any video of where I was sitting, but Dane was way to the left of me, about probably 15, 20 yards, and I was sitting where we sat the day we shot his bird. When those birds dropped down into the field, about four or five of those hens just immediately came to the decoys, and at one point I had hens within like 8 yards of me, and we've been hunting without a blind to be more mobile, and so like my movement was very minimal. I mean, that first hen hit the ground and I didn't move an inch until the second pair of toms got to the decoys. And as soon as they got to the decoys, those hens actually started walking towards me, like right at me. And I just couldn't move. Finally, those toms got to the decoys and they were so preoccupied. I knew I was probably going to spook the hens, but the toms wouldn't probably leave. And I went to full draw, and the hens started popping, and I thought for sure, I knew I didn't have much time. And centered, everything felt really, really good. Shot, heard it connect, but I knew it didn't sound as good as I wanted it to. It sounded very fleshy, and it just didn't have a crunch like I hit any form of bone. Like if you listen to Dane, if you watch the video with Dane's bird, you can hear that very distinct just thump, because he ended up hitting a wing and a leg, and he did what he needed to do to that bird. And then on top of that, when that bird got out there and just kind of stood there and looked, and when he just stood there and looked, and then walked a little further and looked, and got to the edge of the field and looked, I knew it wasn't great. When he got to the edge of the field, I kind of ran after him a little bit, because I didn't. Turkeys can be tough when they're injured. They don't bleed a whole lot. They bleed more internally usually, it seems like, because they just do. I don't know why. But, and he met up with that other tom that he was standing there with, and the, like, 12 hens that were there, and they ran down the creek. So, I went back to my arrow, and it had feathers on it, which is pretty normal, but it had feathers all along it, and then on top of that, it had fat, and it had some breast meat on it. Bottom line is, I hit it in the breast, and I'm not exactly sure where, but it was not a lethal hit. I'm not happy that that bird is walking around with a hole in it, but the bird will survive. Turkeys are a lot tougher than people think. I'm not happy about it. I'm gonna probably be looking for that turkey now. He's gonna be a very tough bird to kill now, but whatever. Essentially what happened, I went back, I didn't take any video of it because I was flustered, at least I don't think, maybe Dane did, but there was a little little like sapling right in front of me, about 8 yards or so. And when I realized it was there, it was too light for me to go break it and to remove it from that area. And I should have just gotten up and did it. Even if I had messed up my turkey hunt, I should have just gotten up and broken it, because I ended up hitting it. And I mentally prepared to make sure that I did not hit that. But what I was not prepared for was 7 hens to walk right at me and get to 8 yards, and for my heart to beat out of my chest the way it did. I mean, I was shaking. I haven't shaken that bad in a long time, you know, not shooting at a deer, not shooting at a turkey. That was, like, intense, and it, you know, unfortunately, it's a kind of a live and learn kind of situation. It's a very similar situation to something that happened to me a couple years ago. Me and my dad missed a turkey because, you know, we got caught and we sat in a little brush pile and, I hit a branch. And it's just the way it goes sometimes. I told Dane, it seems like every year I have some form of a mess up and missed opportunity like that. You know, I tend, with my bow, I seem to miss a turkey once a year. I don't know, I think it's the strutting turkeys. I don't think I'm very good at shooting strutting turkeys. I think I get, like, almost, from a waterfowl's perspective, it's like I flock shoot, almost. I just see, you know, a butterball standing in front of me, and I get so zoned in on that that I don't see the surroundings, and I don't, you know. Dane made a really good point to me, and though I do believe the main issue was the branch, I did not think about this. He talked about how he picks out a specific feather to shoot at, so that he makes sure he's aiming, essentially. And, you know, I won't deny the fact that sometimes I have a tendency just to kind of shoot for vital, because I know where vital is, but I don't, like, aim for vital. Like, I just shoot for that spot because I know that's where I'm supposed to shoot, instead of, like, really making sure that I hit where I want to. And it's definitely, I thought about that, and I'm thinking about it as I drive home. It's something I'm going to have to reevaluate and try a little harder at. But, oh well, I'm just going to learn from the situation. I know the bird's not out there laying dead. I mean, these turkeys probably get worse wounds on them from, beating each other up this time of year. I mean, I'm actually not convinced I didn't just skim him, because one of my broadhead, I'm shooting that muzzy tricorn, something hybrid, and so it's got two expandable blades, and actually one of the blades, it could have closed back up when it hit the dirt, but it looks like it didn't actually open all the way properly. So I'm not convinced that I actually, like, put a hole. I think I skimmed the turkey, because there's, like, one little section of blood on the arrow, and then the rest of it's fat and a little bit of breast meat. But the big thing that's on the arrow is there's all the way up and down it, there's a lot of that fine feather material that, the under feather, the warm section of the feathers, there's a lot of that on it. So I'm rambling. Hope you guys enjoyed that video, even though I missed. Heck of a hunt, super intense, and though I'm mad, I'm going to enjoy that hunt for sure. it is what it is.